All right. Hi, and welcome, everybody. Today, I want to talk about climate change, air travel, and how a PhD in electrical and computer engineering might contribute to the solution to this. We all know that air travel is one of the biggest polluting factors of climate change nowadays. What might surprise you is that we actually already know the solution to this. For short-range flights, we're switching to electric, which Harbour Air right here in Vancouver is actually doing already. And for long-haul flights, we already know that the fuel of the future is going to be hydrogen. We can burn it in our engines that we have today, and everything that comes out of it at the end is just water vapor. So why aren't we using it yet? Well, the problem is hydrogen is the smallest atom by a mile. It's very, very tiny, so even the smallest crack in our gang of prison wardens you see in the back here, aka the walls of our tanks, will lead to hydrogen escaping. In fact, it's not possible to keep hydrogen in a tank for longer than a week nowadays, even with the technology we have. But what's the solution? Well, the solution for us is trying to monitor the tank to see these tiny cracks appear to make sure that your aircraft has enough fuel when it arrives at its destination and that it can do the return trip so we can patch it up if it lost a little bit of hydrogen in that flight. So how do we do this? Well, we created a sensor. This sensor is going to listen to that this tiny crack is going to make. You can't see a picture of the sensor right now because the sensor is actually the 10th of a width of a human hair. And it looks kind of abstract. We do use the technology that we use for chip manufacturing to build these sensors. The way these work is that you can think of them as tiny drums. Each drum is as the size that I just mentioned, and we have an electric field between the two membranes of those drums. The incoming wave of the signal that we get from the crack is going to move the membrane, going to change the electric field, is going to give us an electric signal. So right behind me, you see one of those electric signals. We can already detect them. How do we find out where the crack is, though? Well, if I do this, and now you can see in the back, people just looked up from their phone, straight looked at me. How did they find out where I actually am? Well, the sound reached one ear faster than the other. So this is the exact way we're going to do this. We have a network over the tank. We're going to listen to the cracks coming in. And because we have several sensors, we can immediately say where exactly the crack was. So when the plane lands, we can put a patch on it. We can keep the hydrogen in a tank. We can keep it from escaping. We can make you reach your destination without landing in the ocean somewhere. And we can finally make our trees happy again by changing climate change. Thank you very much.